I have a feeling that the liturgy of today has a different taste, especially after we heard the gospel of today. The liturgy of today, as all the liturgies are, is to share in the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. Christ lived his life on earth. Christ suffered. Christ died. Christ rose from the dead. Christ ascended into heaven. All these events are personal events in the life of the incarnated Word of God and the life of Christ. But now comes the important question: how can I share in that, or how can the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ becomes my resurrection? And I feel that this is a message of the liturgy of today, is to have the life that Christ lived as your life, and is to have the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ as your resurrection. How this can happen in my life and in your life? The answer is in the gospel of today. It is part from the gospel of St. John, chapter 6, beginning with verse 35 to the verse 45. Listen what our Lord Jesus Christ said, and I will tell you very little comments on what he said. Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst." You are living now the physical life because you eat and because you drink. Imagine that for some reason you stopped eating or you stopped drinking. How can you live? So in the spiritual sense, we need to eat and we need to drink that we may have life and that we may have eternal life. And here our Lord Jesus Christ presents himself as the bread and as the drink for us to eat and to drink. He said, "I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst." He's offering himself to us as a drink, as a food, as a bread, and as a drink. "But I said to you that you have seen me, and yet do not believe." Sorrowful to say this or to hear this, that the people at his time saw Christ but did not believe in him. I wish none of us is in this status, that he heard about Christ but he doesn't believe in Christ. Verse 37, "All that the Father gives me will come to me, And here in this section, in the Gospel of St. John, I counted how many times our Lord Christ mentioned the word Father, or referred to him with a pronoun, and I found at least six. In 37, all that the Father gives me will come to me. And then he said in 38, I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And him who sent me is the Father. This is number two. In verse 39, he said, this is the will of the Father who sent me. This is number three. Count with me, please. In verse 40, and this is the will of him who sent me. The will of him who sent me. This is number four. Him who sent me is the Father. And then in verse 44, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him. This is number five, the Father who sent me. And then in verse 45, they shall be taught by God. He refers to God the Father. This is number six. There is one more. And then he said, everyone who has heard and learned from the Father come to me. Then there are seven times in this paragraph or in this section from John 6, he refers to the Father. So what does this mean? It means that you can't come by your initiative to Christ alone, but you need that the Father himself draw you to Christ. The Father himself leads you to Christ. And the Father does this by his Holy Spirit. Then the Father, by his Holy Spirit, lead you to Christ. And that is the reason that not all the people believe in Christ. Those who believe in Christ are those who are really drawn by or led by the Spirit of the Father, and they believed in Christ. And no one can say that Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. So today, we are very thankful to God the Father because he led us and he is leading us to Christ. And this is my prayer today for you and for myself. O Heavenly Father, take me into your Christ. Lead me into Christ. Introduce me to Christ. And what happened after that? When the Father leads us to Christ, then Christ becomes our food and our drink. Then our food and our drink becomes the reason of life. And then through Christ, Christ leads us again to be in unity and in the presence of the Father. It is something easy to understand if the Holy Spirit anointed your mind that today we live in an amazing experience with the Holy Trinity. Today I am led by the Father, by the Spirit of the Father to Christ. Today I am going to be united with Christ through his body and his blood. And today, as I am united with Christ, the life of Christ becomes my life. The resurrection of Christ becomes my resurrection. The eternal life of Christ becomes my eternal life. The unity between the Father and the Son becomes the unity between me with the Father and the Son. Today we are invited to an amazing fellowship with the Father and the Son through the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. All that the Father gives me will come to me. And the one who comes to me, I will by no means cast out. Thank you, our Lord Jesus Christ, for such wonderful promise that if you come to Christ, he will never say to you, go out. For I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. I came from heaven to do the will of God the Father. What is the will of the Father? In verse 39, this is the will of the Father who sent me, that of all he has given me, I should lose nothing, but should raise it up as the last day. This is the will of the Father. The will of the Father is to be raised up, is to have the same resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, is to be raised with Christ and to be seated with him in heaven. This is our inheritance in Jesus Christ our Lord. And verse 40, and this is the will of him who sent me, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have everlasting life. And I will raise him up at the last day. So from the beginning, this was the logos in the mind of God, or this was the plan or the design in the mind of God, that Christ will come in flesh. Christ would live his life on earth. Christ would die. Christ would raise from the dead. And this is for the purpose, not only for the person of Christ, but the design of the Father was for us, that we may have everlasting life, and that Christ will raise up, will raise us as the last day. Today the procession of the resurrection is not only the procession of Jesus' resurrection. Today the procession of the resurrection is our procession of resurrection of Christ. And again he confirms the same meanings with the Jews when he told them, do not murmur among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him. You need that the Father draw you to Christ, lead you to Christ. This should be your prayer today. Lead me into Christ. Lead me to know the depths of Christ. Lead me to know the love of Christ. Lead me to know the humility of Christ. Lead me to have the holiness of Christ. Lead me into the life of Christ. Lead me into Christ. Lead me to be in Christ. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. It is written in the prophets, and these shall be taught by God. God will teach you how to live in Christ. God will lead you how to live in Christ. Therefore, everyone who has heard and learned from the Father, come to me. The liturgy of today should be a liturgy to pray to God the Father that He may empower us and strengthen us by His Holy Spirit to know Christ more, to believe in Christ more, to be in Christ more, to be fed and united with Christ, to have His body and His blood as the food or as the bread or as the drink for our life here with Him and for the eternal life. Christos Anesti, glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.